He's going to let you lie down just now and let you hear from God, and then you're going to your maagie vol oogies toe. Have some holy sleep. All right, so we're going to go into the soaking part. All right, but before we let you soak, we need just to give you a little bit of a foundation for soaking and why we use the word soaking and what that means. The best expression I've ever had was if you take a sponge that is dry, you know, just these normal sponges that you do your cutlery with, whatever. But when it's dry and you take a drop of water and you put it on the sponge, it doesn't immediately get sucked in. It lies on top of the sponge. It takes the sponge a while and then it gets drawn in. And that is the same concept, that we just get ourselves comfortable in the presence of the Lord and inviting the Holy Spirit to come and to become wet in the presence of the Lord, to soak the presence of God. That is actually basically what it means. There's some ministries that even have soaking sessions. People come together to the church to soak. And the reason is the benefits of soaking is the revelation that comes, personal revelation, God speaking to you. There's more ways to do it. We've got team members. When we begin to host soaking, we have guys that minister to people soaking, because sometimes the Lord gets busy with people and you can touch somebody's shoulder and just say, Lord, we just bless what you're doing in this person's life. But we don't prophesy to them, we don't shake them or do funny stuff with people. Leave people, the Lord's busy with them. You know, that's the whole idea. Now, today we're going to do some practical. The thing is, just don't become discouraged, because sometimes when you do it, you think it's difficult. It can take up to 20 minutes for you just to become quiet, because the mind is racing. And you have to, and that's why you have to write it down. All right, but let's quickly share with you. Is all getting wet when we soak in the presence of the Lord? Yes and no. It is not, depending on your life and your circumstances and what you present to the Lord today will determine a lot by what you experience today. But the good thing is you can take this home and you can go and put up music and you can just go and lie there and you can just invite the Holy Spirit to come and say, Lord, just soak me in your presence. The problem is sometimes we are really tired and we are stressed and you fall asleep. And that's okay if you fall asleep. If you're tired, your body says, he gave me some rest at last, so I'm going to take this opportunity and snore away in the presence of God. It's happened often in our soaking sessions that somebody so say, you can't more sleep. Let me so snore. Softer, broer. There's nothing you can do, and you don't feel bad about it. Something you can do every day. So if you fall asleep, We call it holy sleep. God wants you to rest. There's no performance clause in this. And you can always do it. So why soak? Why do we soak? There's a deep need in every one of us to be close to God. It's in our design. As somebody described, we've got a God-shaped vacuum inside of us, in every human heart that longs to be fulfilled. To soak in God's presence is to rest in His love rather than to strive in prayer. To wait patiently for a touch from God that begins to connect with you in the reality of the presence of the Holy Spirit. Just here I am, Lord. Just come and touch me. Soaking in His presence opens up the heart and our soul to divine romance and intimacy with God. It allows the Lord to love you and for you to love Him. You will find that your love and intimacy will deepen as you spend more and more time together. There must be time for Him, just to love Him and let Him love us. No other agendas, no shopping list or prayer requests. Those may come later, but you need to put loving Him first, because only as we are filled with His love, so do we have love to give away. You cannot give what you do not have. You can only give what you received. So the idea is not to use soaking as a tool for God to answer all my questions. Soaking is to spend time in intimacy with God. And I don't ask the Lord a question, say, what do you have for me? I just wait for Him to surprise me. I just wait for Him to show me anything. I'm open to anything He wants to show me. I don't have the specific request. We're going to use music when we tell you to find a place. This is a nice church for soaking. Eddie Bonker is quite nice. We will let you know when we go home. Sy sê, kerk is uit. Ons het al 1/2 uur gewag. All right. Why do I need to soak? What is the need? Well, if you are spiritually dry, soaking can revitalize your spirit. If you long to move more powerfully in the gifts of the Spirit, soaking can help you to hear God clearly. If you are looking for fresh vision and direction in life, soaking can bring it. If you are hurting inside, soaking can ease your pain. If you are about to start something new and need the Lord's strengthening, soaking can refresh you. If you are searching for an answer to some problem or situation, soaking can help you find the way. If you carry responsibilities, soaking can lift the burden. If you are trapped in habitual sin, soaking can empower you to break free. And just on that point, you know, because the church in general is so often sin conscious, the problem with sin teaching is not that we soften our stance on sin. It is the condemnation that comes with it that is contradictory to the message of the cross. Jesus came to set you free. See, if you are bound, the good news is He came to set you free. He did not come to reject you. And often, the presence of perceived sin in our lives brings that disqualification and expectation of judgment on our lives so much that you don't expect the Holy Spirit to speak to you while you're doing what you're doing, whatever you're doing. All right. If you are trapped in that sin, soaking can help you to be free. Because the Lord's going to come to you and say, I love you. I don't want you to be bound up in these things. If you're having relational difficulties, soaking can give us a new resource of grace, patience, and love. It's allowing the love of God just to pour over us. If you simply just want to have more intimacy with the Heavenly Father, soaking can take you deeper into that. How do I begin? This is weird when people say, come to church, bring a pillow and a blanket. Imagine visitors driving past you. Yes, this is a lekker kerk hier. Check him out, rock a bears and kissings again. This is a lekker church. Well, that pastor must be very boring. It's like the little boy that came to the pastor and came out. He said, Pastor, one day when I'm grown up, I'm going to give you a lot of money. He says, thank you, my boy. Why? He says, my dad says, you're the poorest preacher he's ever seen. All right. How do I begin? We invite people to lie down. That's crazy. You say, what doctrine is this now of lying down? Listen, before you fall, just lie down. No, we're joking. It's just the best position to rest. You must put you at a place where you can be quiet. So lying down was found to say, well, we're going to share some scriptures, but just relax. You can sit. One thing I would not advise you to do is don't soak while you drive. Those of you that are familiar with the drunken old days, don't soak when you drive. It's not a good idea. I think the Lord is responsible, but you can get drunk in the Holy Spirit while driving. You can. Don't do it. Okay, lie down on the floor, sit in a chair, or lie on your bed. The main thing is to be in a safe, restful place so that you can be vulnerable. Set your affection on Jesus. Soaking while listening to intimate music will help you, your soul to help you draw near to God. After a few moments, you'll become aware of the Holy Spirit's presence. You might experience a weight upon your body or tingling in your hands or face. You may feel a warm sensation of love going through your heart, which connects you to Him. You may pray a prayer like this, Lord Jesus, I invite you to come and search my heart. Come close and let me know your love. Let worship rise up inside of you. Give yourself to the Lord. But the thing is, don't start praying in tongues. You're going to disturb the person next to you. In your home, you want to wait. You don't want to do. It's a place of resting, not doing. Okay. Don't try to force things. Just relax. Take time to be with him and let him just love you. Just be aware of his love poured over you. If you fall asleep, that's okay. If you're interrupted, you can always come back for more later. You can go home and do it. What I find in the beginning, if you're not used to soaking, sometimes it's just short, you're done. What I have found is in settings like this, sometimes it just takes 10 to 15 minutes just to kind of get to a peaceful place, because that's how rushed we are in life. If I give my mind any kind of gap, it takes it to sort out all the unsorted stuff in my life. And that's why you need to write them down. So practical thing is, if you lie down, focus on, you have to go through the four keys. I quiet myself down, I focus on Jesus. You have to focus on Jesus, otherwise you're going to start looking into the things that present itself in your thinking. Oh, I must do this, I must remember that. Or, you know, your system, your own, you can sometimes experience a vision that is distracted from what Jesus is showing you because your mind is full of a lot of things. If you realize this thing is taking me away from his love and his presence, stop it. Go back. When I soak, I have to do that many times sometimes. Just, whoa, I'm on a rabbit trail here. Just write it down. Let me pray about that thing. But I want to get back to Jesus. I want, you know, I'm giving him that time. And we spoke about this now in this break, is that we don't want to see this as a responsibility. Oh, I need to soak. If it's not out of love, don't do it. Don't let it become another chore in your life. Do it when your heart is yearning for him. Do it because you love him. Don't do it because you think he expects you to do that. All right. Just relax. It takes 5 to 10 minutes sometimes just to stop thinking about normal activities of life. Can I trust the Holy Spirit? In Luke 11:11, the Lord says that he will not give you a snake and a stone if you ask for the Holy Spirit. Trust the Lord. Who is the one that saved you? His name is Jesus. Trust him. Okay. You're coming before him. You're trusting him. You're trusting the Holy Spirit. Okay. Biblical basis. Just a biblical basis for soaking. Just a couple of scriptures. Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd. You know that one well. I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. Psalm 131, I have stilled and quieted my soul, like a weaned child with his mother, like a weaned child is my soul within me. I'm satisfied. A baby that's weaned, life says, I've been sucking on my mother's breast, I'm full, I'm happy, I'm in a safe place, that's where I want to be. Psalm 4, meditate within your heart, on your bed, and be still. Lie on your bed and just think about the Lord, man. Psalm 37, be still before the Lord and wait patiently for him. That's what we do when we soak. We just wait for him. Just, Lord, just lavish your love on me. Just speak to me. And then Matthew 11, come to me all who are heavy laden. His burden is light, yoke soft. Know that scripture? All right. So what we have included, if you don't, you need to get the stuff that they post to you. You can print yourself one of these. It is called a Soaking in God's Presence Step-to-Step Guide. It gives you all the scriptures that you can do, how to do, what are the quiet times, all these things, how to soak, everything. Actually, we could have just given this to you and spared you 3 sessions. But not really, but it does say a lot. It's really a nice thing to have. Also, if you want to give it to somebody else, to say, if you want to do some soaking, it's got all the scriptures and it's got quite a bit of information on this leaflet. All right. They do have it, yes, so they can say that you can print it there. All right. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to go into the practical part of soaking. So what we're going to do is we're going to put on music. You need to find a comfortable place. You need to move around. You can lie on the carpet. You can lie on the bench, I suppose. The whole idea for you is just to get away from a person right next to you. So that you can, and then we want to practice the four keys. We want to quiet ourselves down. We want to focus on Jesus. We want to tune to the spontaneous flow. We want to write it down. And that's why you had to bring a notebook. But you can use your phone or whatever. These days, luckily, there's many ways to record. But you want to record it. But you also want to record if you have these random thoughts. And that's where it helps me a lot as well. I have my book. It's amazing what comes up in your mind when you become quiet. All your responsibilities just pops up. Write it down. I must remember this. You don't want to give it focus. You want to give focus on Jesus at that moment. So you want to get away from all the other stuff that spontaneously pop up in your head. You're going to experience that. Some people take a long time before they can actually become quiet and just focus on Jesus. If you lose focus on Jesus, just go back. See the cross. See a picture of Jesus. And when you begin to experience something like a picture, look at that picture. Ask the Lord, Lord, what are you trying to show to me? And then write it down. All right. And then we're going to give you, we want to try and be finished around about 2. So if I say if we can do about 20 minutes of soaking, then we just want to give one or two people, say, what did you experience? What did you see? Did you find that this work? Just so that people can see it actually works. All right, if that's okay with you. And then we will then close. But thank you for giving me the opportunity to share some of those these experiences with you. It has really been my honor. Thank you for feeding me. And if I snore, just give me a kick. We usually don't feed people before we do soaking because it is like heavy eyelids. Dis hoekom ek nie 'n tweede porsie gevat het nie. Die kos was baie lekker, maar. Let's get you soaking. You guys do have music. We put on some instrumental. I just want to say this. I don't soak with music, personally. I soak in dead quiet. Because the moment that they're singing, it draws my attention to the words. And then I struggle. You get other people, they just love it, man. They just begin to worship and stuff. So we're all different. So I can soak. I've done a lot of soaking in my life, so I can well manage to soak with instrumental. We're putting up instrumental music. But let's just pray. Let's just ask the Holy Spirit to help us that our knowledge or what we heard today will be put into an experience. Father, we just thank you that you are our Father and that you love us. And it's your desire to speak to each and every person that's here. You love them with all the love that is in you. You knew them before birth. You are acquainted with all their ways, our strength, our weaknesses, our battles. There's nothing hidden from you. And Lord, as we ready ourselves just to allow your Holy Spirit to come and pour into our hearts, we ask you to speak to us. We ask you to open up our spiritual eyes and the eyes of our hearts, and that this will not just be the continuation of something good, but the beginning of something new and fresh for all of us, where we experience in a deeper and a more meaningful way, not from any man's hand, but from the heart of the Father himself, from the Holy Spirit, from Jesus. Lord, and that we are your sons, and that we are your daughters, and that you love us. We open up your hearts now, Holy Spirit, that you will come. In Jesus' name.